pick up Hallie tonight. Make sure we get back to VBS and find Captain B. I want to find Captain B. Hallie, come on, it's time for VBS. We got to find Captain B. We didn't find him last night. Oh, let me open the door for you. There you go. Come on, get in. Make sure you get your seatbelt on. We'll get, what was it we needed? A flux capacitor or something? I don't know, but our car goes back in time. It's awesome. Let's go. Whoa! Oh, goodness gracious. That was fast. Hey, we're here.
Again?
We're back. We could not find Mr. B, Captain B last night.
Oh, you have to find Captain B. This is so cool tonight.
Oh, good.
I'm going to tell you what. Get ready for some action and go find Mr. B.
Captain B. Well, hello. How are you?
This is an update from what we're looking at for tonight.
Okay. Get ready.
We're tuning my gadget box. Let's listen.
Transmitter, he's breaking up, but I think we can listen. And here's some more
important phrases. Where is he? He said living water.
Living water? Living water?
Ooh, get out of that stream.
If he'd open his mask, we might could hear him.
Prepare the way.
Living water, prepare the way.
It must be about my father's business.
Oh,
he's at the same Galloway. Fishers of men.
Wow.
Children, he was moving so fast, but I think I got some stuff written down that may help us. Okay, prepare the way of the Lord, my father's business. Fishers of men, also he said, the living water, all these things, they're so important. We have to know where Captain B is. I think we can find him. Help me out.
All right, we're here to help.
All right,
we're going to the Memory Verse station. We got our Memory Verse tonight, right? Hey there!
Hey.
Hey, we're back, and she has her memory verse for tonight. She wants a prize.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, let's hear it.
Whereas you do not know what will happen tomorrow, for what is your life? It is a vapor that appears for a little time and then vanishes away.
Wow.
Woo! Yes.
14.
That's good.
All right.
What would you like?
We have a few goodies here, so what would you like?
Ooh, that is awesome. Paw Patrol puzzles.
I'll take some bubbles.
Bubbles. Awesome. Okay. Bubbles.
Good choice.
Thank you. We'll be back tomorrow night for another Memory Verse.
Yes.
All right. Oh, look. It's Professor Dynamite again. Oh, no. He's in the way. What is he doing?
Steven.
Hey.
You are here.
Dynamite. We're back.
Halle Berry. Bishop, how are you? Okay, guys. So glad that you helped me out last night. Now, do you remember? Where was Captain B last night?
He was all over the place.
All
over
the place.
King David.
Abraham.
And, Noah. I mean, he was in Moses.
Moses.
He was everywhere.
Where is that in the Bible? Is it in the Old Testament or the New Testament? Do we know?
Old Testament.
You are correct. So I think tonight that he is traveling to the New Testament.
Ooh.
So we will have to be careful. Make sure that we keep an eye out for Captain B, okay? Now, You'll go into the time machine, turn off the car, you keep the windows and the top down like cool dudes that you are, and then wait for the video message, and then it will open and you'll be ready to go.
Okay?
Are you guys ready?
We're ready.
All right, let's hit it.
All right. I'm Mr. Larry.
Good luck. I hope you make it back.
Ooh, oh, this is so cool. With the lights again, I remember.
Gotta turn our car off. Okay. Oh, good. You brought your family. Now, we're gonna need everybody's help. Make sure your seatbelts are buckled.
Got it.
Make sure that the flux capacitors are on.
Got
Mr.
it.
Larry, my assistant, he has helped us with this, and we'll be ready when the time comes. Now, be sure that you travel at a safe speed. There will be Bible characters walking around, and do not leave your car for any reason. You must stay in your car, lest you be left in the Bible times. Okay, I'm going to adjust it. Hold on, here we go.
Hold on.
We have been seeing some suspicious people here in the marketplace. Mm. You want to help me get rid of them? You know the booster song?
Not him.
You ready?
Booster, booster, be a booster. Don't be grouchy like a rooster. Booster, booster, be a booster. Booster Bible School. Boost!
Hey, thank you for getting rid of him. He's been over here.
He almost stole the bread.
He's been haggling us.
I was just getting bread. What happened?
You're just getting bread.
Yeah,
I don't know. Somebody tried to steal the bread.
Oh, well, we have a craft for you here.
Oh, no, a craft.
A sample of the craft.
A sample. We're not going to take the craft tonight. We're just gonna make the craft. That's right.
Oh,
there's cookies. Ooh, those are my favorite. Oreos. Man, that's great.
Maybe Hallie will give you some.
Yeah, maybe she will. I still have my eye on that candle over here.
Which ones?
Or maybe that leopard print. Oh, well, never mind. It's time to go. I'll get that later. It's still hot out here. This is young Jesus.
Hello, welcome. I'm Joseph, and this is my wife, Mary.
Oh. Well,
you know, our son Jesus, you know, sometimes he does things that are a little different. You know, just the other day, we had gone to the Feast of Passover, and we've been traveling to the Feast of Passover. And we had a good time, and we took Jesus there, and he was 12 years old. But when we were traveling home, we couldn't find him anywhere. We couldn't find Jesus anywhere.
Oh, and I was so worried. I mean, we looked, and we looked, and we asked our friends and our family, but nobody had seen Jesus.
Couldn't find him anywhere.
We decided we would head back to Jerusalem, and guess what? We found him. We found him in the temple.
In the temple?
Yes. And he had been there for 3 whole days, listening to teachers and asking them questions, but we were so thankful we had found him.
Yeah, you know, the people there, they were amazed at how many things he understood. And we asked Jesus, you know, what are you doing? What were you thinking? And he said, did you not know that I must be about my Father's business? Can you believe he said that? Did you not know that I must be about my Father's business?
That's it.
I mean, that's what he said. I don't know. I tell you, he does things a little different.
That is awesome. Hey, you know what? That is amazing. It's our secret phrase.
It's a secret phrase.
It's a secret phrase for us to get through Bible times and find Captain B. We cannot find Captain B. Have you
Captain
seen him?
B.
I haven't seen him. Who is Captain B?
He's lost in the
Bible.
What
kind of clothes does he wear?
He's like an astronaut.
Oh.
Do you know what an astronaut is?
No, I don't know.
Oh, well, it's the guy that travels in space.
Is he somebody from Arabia?
No.
Oh, okay.
Space.
Right.
But anyway, he's lost in Bible times, and we're trying to find him.
Maybe he's over that way.
Oh. Okay. Well, hello there.
Hello. One day while I was in the wilderness by this beautiful river, I was eating my locusts, drinking my honey out of my nice little flask. That's what I have to eat every day. And as I was doing so, a group of people came up to me, consisting of priests and scribes. And they says, who are you? Are you Elijah? Or are you the prophet? I says, I am neither one. I am the person that Isaiah the prophet said, the voice of one crying into the wilderness, John the Baptist.
Oh, I know John the Baptist.
Yeah,
I've heard of him.
So I'm going about and I'm preparing the way for the Lord. Why? Baptizing people, but my baptism is different than Jesus because I am baptizing for repentance of sin, or unto repentance. But yet there's one greater than I that is coming that I'm preparing the way for, and that is Jesus. And he's mightier than I, and I'm not even worthy to carry his sandals.
No.
When he comes, he's going to baptize you for the remission of sins. He's going to baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire.
That is awesome.
Now, as you, as I was going about the next day then, eating my locusts, drinking my honey, I looked up and behold, here comes Jesus walking toward me. And I says, behold, here is the Lamb of God, the one I've been preparing the way for. Jesus comes up and he asks me, he says, would you please baptize me? So I went down into the water, I baptized Jesus. When he came up out of the water, then a spirit from heaven came down in the shape of a dove and lit on his shoulder. Mm. And a voice from heaven said, this is my beloved son, hear ye him.
Wow.
At that point, I realized that my time of preparing the way for the Lord was complete.
Wow. That's awesome. Hey, while we're looking for Captain B. Have you seen Captain B? He's like an astronaut.
No, I chased him away last night.
Oh, okay. Well, we'll keep looking for him.
Maybe you'll find him.
This is the well of Jacob. Jacob was our father. This is the well of Jacob where we come to get water. Well, 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 well. We all come here to the well. When the day gets hotter, we dip our bucket in the well and then we get our water. Well, hello.
Hello, how are
you? Welcome. Would y'all like some water?
Oh, man, I'll tell you what, you can fill up my bottle here. That would be great.
I see you've got nothing to draw water out of the well with. You know, we've had lots of visitors here recently, but there's one visitor that's really stuck out to me. Have you ever heard of Jesus of Nazareth?
Yes.
You have? Well, he was here, right here, a couple of days ago. He was a Jew, and he actually spoke to me, and I'm a Samaritan. Y'all probably don't know this because you're just traveling through, but Jews don't speak to Samaritans.
Oh, I've heard that.
This man, though, was different. And he even spoke to a lowly Samaritan like me, but that was just the beginning of it. Not only did he speak to me, he asked me for a drink. And then he started talking to me about living water. and how I should be asking him for this living water. At first, I thought he was just a prophet. He told me specific things about my life that I just didn't think anybody else would ever know. But then he continued talking. He talked to me about worship and how, did you know it doesn't matter where you worship as long as you worship in spirit and in truth? I told him, though, that I knew there was a Messiah called the Christ who was coming, and that guy would explain everything to us. He didn't have to worry about it. Do you know what he told me?
What?
He told me he was the Messiah, the Christ.
No way.
Can you believe that? That I was talking to the Messiah, the Christ, and he was talking to me? I had to go into town and tell everybody I knew about it. They didn't believe me at first, but then they came with me and we heard him talk some more, and everybody believed. I'm so glad you guys stopped by today so I could tell you about this Messiah.
Well, thank you. That is awesome. We're looking for this Captain B guy. He's an astronaut, wears a helmet.
I haven't seen him.
Have you seen him?
I haven't. I mean, I'm by the well all the time, but I haven't seen him.
Well, thanks for telling us the story. That was great. We learned a lot. Hey, guys.
Hey, well, how's it going?
Hey, we're looking for a Captain B. Have y'all seen a Captain B?
A who?
A Captain B.
Mm.
He's an astronaut, wears a helmet, white suit.
Is B short for Bartholomew?
No.
No, not Bartholomew. I've heard.
Well,
okay,
well,
I've heard of this place called Captain D's that maybe we sell our fish to before. I don't know.
Yeah, that's fine. We got plenty. We're about to take it out.
Oh, well, what are y'all doing? This is great.
Yeah, well, I'm Peter. This is Andrew.
How's it going?
I guess we're just going to tell about how we met Jesus. And it was really kind of an exciting story. What was that, back in 43? I don't remember.
Yeah, 42, 43, something like that.
Yeah, anyways, we were out fishing the whole day, if we wanted to call it fishing. Didn't catch a single thing. Okay, get back. Very frustrated, long day, it was hot. And all of a sudden, this man comes walking down the hill, and he's like, hey, yo, I need to use your boat. We're like,
it was kind of weird. It was weird.
You ain't going to use my boat.
Wow.
Whatever. We said, okay, you can use the boat. Took him out, and he starts preaching to this crowd on the shore. And so, it's very interesting. This is something we hadn't really heard before. But basically, I'll just say, then after that, it's what?
What was the Captain B back there?
Oh, yeah.
I'm sorry to interrupt.
No, that's fine. Yeah, story about Jesus, not important. That's okay.
Oh, okay. Yeah, well, keep going. Okay.
Anyways, he basically, after all that, he told us to cast our nets into fish. We said, Jesus, I know that you're new around here, but we were doing this all day. We're this is kind of our profession.
Literally all day.
Didn't catch a single thing, so I think it's pretty dry today. Anyways, we cast our net. Okay.
It's
next thing
like
we know,
this
we
net
saw.
Over here that's empty.
Yeah, it was this net right here.
Oh wow.
Yeah, it's the first one we used. And next thing we knew, we had two whole nets of it. I mean, I'm talking so much fish, it was sinking our boats. So we had to call James and John. But wasn't James and John?
James and John. They were in another boat. We had to get a second boat.
Had to help
come
us
out
lift
and help
it.
Us.
It was wild.
Oh my goodness, so many fish.
Yeah, that was pretty. We kind of started believing then, okay, maybe this Jesus guy is a little something different that we might need to follow. So,
wasn't there something weird he told us at the end?
Well, yeah, right after that, he asked us to follow him, and he said, you know, you've been fishing all your life, but I'm not going to make you fishers of men.
Yeah, that's what it was.
Fishers of men. That's a secret phrase for us.
A secret phrase?
For helping us to find Captain B.
Fishers of men. Interesting.
This is great.
Thanks to Jesus, we got all this fish. And
oh, my goodness. Let me see the fish. Let's see what I got. Oh, my God. Look at all those fish.
They're dead.
Goodness gracious. Okay, well, we've got our secret phrases. We're going to keep looking for Captain B. Thank you for the story.
I hope you find
Captain
B. Hope you find whoever you're looking for.
Okay, all right. No. Hey, guess what? Last night, we lost our crayon, but we found a crayon. All right. And we have a second one, and she got all the passphrases.
Okay, well, just keep
but we couldn't find Captain B.
Couldn't find Captain B.
Okay.
All right, ready?
We get a prize again? Oh, awesome. I guess this time you just go through. Let's see. We're back. Oh yeah, I remember these two. They didn't talk very much. Hey, we're back again.
Have a good night.
We're still looking for Captain B. Have you seen him?
I have not.
Oh, okay. Maybe next time.